But that big problem, because what I'm going to dive into is another big problem that's relevant. I was talking to a good friend of mine last night, Tom Bender, who mentioned back in the late 1800s a huge and significant problem that they're dealing with that ultimately they finally solved. But that was one of how to deliver electricity to the United States. There are a bunch of smart people working on it. They're listed there, Westinghouse, Edison, J.P. Morgan, and Tesla. They actually had electricity, they had light bulbs, but they had no way to deliver it. They had a huge capability, a huge market, had no idea how to establish a grid, how to create a market around that, and actually how to be profitable in doing so. Some interesting stories around that. It was very cutthroat. In fact, Edison invented the electric chair as a way to effectively point to Westinghouse that AC current was dangerous and bad, and that they should actually be utilizing DC current to push across the nation. So it's interesting to note, maybe something for our notebook is to potentially kill our competitors with their product. but the thing here is that they had a huge problem, a huge opportunity, didn't know what to make of it, and just knew that someday it would not only be everywhere, but it'd actually be a utility that was used every day. So the similarity I'm going to draw here is with the social graph. All, I'm sure, interact with social graphs daily. At GIST, we do a number of things in terms of bringing in quite a bit of data and quite a bit of entities and information from email and from LinkedIn and Facebook. We're currently at about 30 million nodes and growing substantially. We have about 50 million nodes within our data model. LinkedIn also just passed the 50 million node count. But the question really lies is, what is the real use case here? What is the utility? What is the value? There's a great opportunity for the aha moment when it first comes into play. But how do we create something that's innovative and creates real value for the salesperson, the business professional on a daily basis that they can actually gain some traction from? So specifically, if you look at this curve here, what it's trying to show is There's a relationship between the depth of connection and the number of connections that each of us have in our professional world. And obviously, close friends and acquaintances, there's a deep connection graph in terms of the strength of that relationship and the importance of the relationship. But the long tail here is really the business connections that you have, which are numerous. And from our data that we see, just most of our users have between 1,000 and 1,500 person connections and about half as many company connections that they're monitoring and effectively engaging with every year. So if you have all this data and trying to put it to use, what are the things that it can be used for? One, obviously, is finding new connections. So if you have a graph of your own connection and your other folks in your division or your company have other graphs, where is the overlap? How can you make introductions, as well as how can you make introductions outside your company and through multiple degrees of separation? Suggesting people that that I should know because other people in my network know them, or I'm working on a project that needs access to individuals that I don't have direct connections for, so the social graph can be used to hopefully derive how these conversations can take place and where they should take place. The other thing is, how can I visualize a social graph to understand patterns of communication, who the movers and shakers are, where the trends are, and how it changes over time?